Greetings, my friend. Welcome back to Space Enjoyer. Black holes are some of the most enigmatic and powerful objects in the universe. They have captivated scientists and the public alike for decades, and for good reason. The existence of these incredible objects and their impact on the universe forced humanity to look at the cosmos in a completely different way. In this video, we will explore the science behind black holes, find out when and why they are born, how they affect matter, space and time around them, and why even they are probably not eternal and can disappear over time. Given the bizarre character of black holes, it was long questioned whether such objects could actually exist in nature or whether they were merely pathological solutions to Einstein's equations. Einstein himself wrongly thought black holes would not form because he held that the angular momentum of collapsing particles would stabilize their motion at some radius. This led the general relativity community to dismiss all the results to the contrary for many years. However, a minority of relativists continued to contend that black holes were physical objects, and by the end of the 1960s, they had persuaded the majority of researchers in the field that there is no obstacle to the formation of an event horizon. Imagine that you are shooting a cannon vertically upwards from the surface of the Earth. The flight of the cannonball, tending upwards, will be slowed down by the forces of gravity. Eventually, it will stop and fall back to Earth. If the cannonball goes at a speed exceeding a certain critical velocity, it will never stop its flight and will not fall, but will continue to fly away. For the Earth, this velocity is approximately 11 km per second. For the Sun, 618. Both of these speeds exceed the possible flight speed of a cannonball, but it is much less than the speed of light, which is 300,000 km per second. This means that gravity doesn't greatly affect light. Light easily leaves both the Earth and the Sun. When the light passes by the Sun, it deviates very little from the direct path. However, if the Sun shrank to a few kilometers across, the deviation would be so large that light would not be able to leave the Sun, but would be attracted to it by the gravitational field. According to the theory of relativity, nothing can move faster than the speed of light. So, there will be a region that no one and nothing can leave. This region is called a black hole, and its boundary is the event horizon. The radius of the event horizon of a spherically symmetric black hole is determined by its mass. It can be calculated by the equation R equals to 2gm divided by squared c, where g is the gravitational constant, m is the mass of a black hole, and c is the speed of light. Such a radius is called the Schwarzschild radius, in honor of the scientist Karl Schwarzschild, who coined the term in 1916. One of the ways black holes are formed is when a massive star collapses in on itself, creating a gravitational singularity, a condition in which gravity is predicted to be so intense that space-time itself would break down catastrophically. As such, a singularity is by definition no longer part of the regular space-time and cannot be determined by where or when. The other way of black hole formation is so-called Kilonova. A kilonova is an astronomical event that occurs in a compact binary system, when two neutron stars or a neutron star and a black hole merge. These mergers are thought to produce gamma ray bursts and emit bright electromagnetic radiation. Such phenomena also produce detectable gravitational waves, as it occurred on the 17th August 2017, when a gravitational wave signal GW-170817 was observed by the LIGO and Virgo detectors, originating from the Shell elliptical galaxy NGC 4993. The signal was produced by the last minutes of a binary pair of neutron stars in spiral process, ending with a merger. Besides, black holes can eventually form by the collapse of the central part of the galaxy or protogalactic gas. Hypothetically, black holes could also be formed immediately after the Big Bang or during the very high-energy nuclear reactions. Black holes are so powerful that they can consume everything that comes too close, even stars. A star that is unlucky enough to be near a black hole will slowly give up its substance until it disappears completely. But black holes aren't just cosmic vacuum cleaners, they also have incredible effects on the surrounding space. The intense gravity of a black hole warps the fabric of space and time around it, creating such fascinating phenomena as gravitational lensing, where the intense gravity of a black hole bends light around it, creating distorted images of distant objects. Black holes can also cause time dilation, which means that time passes differently depending on your proximity to the black hole. For example, if you were to orbit a black hole, time would appear to move more slowly for you than it would for someone observing from a distance. But even black holes are not eternal and indestructible. The famous physicist Stephen Hawking proposed that black holes emit radiation known as a Hawking radiation due to quantum effects near the event horizon. This radiation causes black holes to slowly evaporate over time, eventually disappearing completely. Black holes continue to challenge our understanding of the universe. From their formation to their effects on the surrounding space, there is still much to learn about these cosmic giants. But one thing is for sure, black holes will continue to capture our imaginations and inspire scientific discovery for years to come. So let's keep exploring the mysteries of the universe and see where they take us. Thank you for your attention. If you liked this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, I appreciate any feedback from you. Space and Joy was with you. See you soon.